at Brandless, you know, you talk about omnichannel. Many of you are thinking about that, and D2C is like a new strategy. But D2C to us, it's not a channel. It's a relationship. Mm. And you really need to think about, like, who you're in relationship with. The people at your table, the people that you're sitting next to here. You're watching somebody take a picture of a slide. You're like, maybe I should take a picture of that slide. Or can you, like, airdrop me that photo? Because it looks like you have a better lens. So, like, all of a sudden, you just built a relationship. Because really, the truth is, a brand isn't what we say about ourselves. It's what a friend tells a friend. And so when we think about disruption, when we think about, like, relationships and channels and people and being in direct relationship, like, that funnel doesn't work anymore because the relationship really starts after the sale. So we think about it like a love loop. And for us, we're in reinventing that funnel because we're always in relationship with the people that we serve. And the path to purchase is way less important than the path to passion and the path to connection and the path to authenticity. And so what does that actually mean, and how do we manifest that at Brandless? Well, we start with conversations. Then we have collaborations. Then we have content and spaces and places and purpose. But let me show you and break down what that actually means so you understand. When we talk about conversations, we literally mean I sit down, our team sits down, and we sit down with people and we talk to them all the time and we get that feedback. Then we collaborate. We collaborate all the time with the people in our community. So what does that actually mean? Many of you are probably sitting down with your CTOs and asking for a shopping cart that is mobile optimized, that takes Apple Pay, that is all of these other things. But what about a shopping cart inside of your Instagram stories? So here's a gal who created these shoe leathers from our organic honey and our organic preserves. We found that story because she tagged us. We then pulled it into our story. We commerce enabled it so you could buy the honey right off of that story. Yeah. So there was the shopping cart right there. People are a community to do that. And then we push it out through all of our channels, whether it's Facebook or Instagram or Twitter or on our own pages or on someone's feed all the time, constant content conversations. And then there's spaces and places. So I like to think of spaces and places as IRL, so in real life. So you saw we were just here in New York for a couple of weeks at our second pop-up with purpose. And so we were down here and people came in and they shopped the aisles and everything was available. We had over 350 products then. We're over 400 now, and that was only 2 months ago. This is, you're saying, well, what are people doing writing in your pop-up? They're writing love notes to people they care about, or if they don't have enough of those people, or they're doing an extra one, and we brought them to senior citizens living in nursing centers. Because our brand is not about any product that we sell. Our brand is about a community that's steeped in kindness and truth and trust and transparency. And this is how you build relationships, by connecting people and making it happen. It also helps when you're serving free snacks. I mean, it's not as good as an open bar, but trust me, it works.